Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start with new topic, that is pronouns. Now first let us see the definition of pronoun and then we'll see what is personal pronoun. A pronoun is a word that takes place of one or more nouns. So what is a pronoun? It is a word that takes place of one or more nouns. It means the word which is used in place of noun. The word used instead of noun is called pronoun. The most frequently used pronouns are called personal pronouns. Now, what are personal pronouns? The pronouns which we use more frequently, they are called personal pronouns. They refer to people or things. So what does these personal pronouns refer to? They refer to people or things. Now personal pronouns are divided into subject pronoun and object pronoun. So let us see what is subject pronoun. A subject pronoun is used as the subject of sentence. Now what is a subject? Subject means the doer of the action, right? So the pronoun which is the doer of the action, that is called as subject pronoun. The pronoun which is used as a subject is called subject pronoun. For example, she is my best friend. Now she is the subject and it is a pronoun. So it is called as subject pronoun. It is my dog. So it is subject pronoun. Does he know the answer? Now who know he? So action is done by whom? He. So this is a subject pronoun. You and I will meet later. So which is the subject pronoun here? You and I. So these are subject pronouns. So subject pronouns is used as a subject of the sentence, as a doer of the sentence. Next is object pronoun. Now what is object pronoun? An object pronoun is used as the direct or indirect object or the object of preposition. Now already you have learned what is direct object, what is indirect object, right? And what is the object of preposition. So the pronoun which is used as an object is called as object pronoun. Give the book to me. Now here me is object pronoun. The teacher gave her a reprimand. So her, this is object pronoun. I will tell you a story. You, it is a object pronoun. Susan read it to them. It and them. Now there are two objects. Let us move ahead. Now personal pronouns are divided into, as I told you, subject pronouns and object pronouns, singular and plural. So the subject pronoun singular I, plural we. Subject pronoun second person singular you, plural you. Third person singular he, she, it and plural they. Now object, now these are subject pronouns, means they are used as the subject of the sentence. Now object pronoun first person singular me, plural us. Second person singular you, plural you. Third person singular him, her, it, plural them. So these pronouns are used as object of the sentence. Let's move ahead. Now pronouns and antecedents. So what do you mean by antecedents? Now let us read the sentences. Arachne competes with Athena. She weaves skillfully. Now this is a sentence. sentence is not clear because the word she could refer to either Archana or Athena. Sometimes you must repeat a noun to rewrite the sentence. Now here, she. In this sentence, she is a pronoun. But now, she means who? Whether Archana or whether Athena. It is not clear. So sometimes we need to rewrite the nouns or repeat the nouns. Now why we use pronouns? To avoid repetition of nouns, isn't it? But sometimes in such cases when the pronoun is means it is not clear about which noun it refers to, then we need to repeat the noun. For example, Archana competes with Athena. Athena views skillfully. Now see, who views skillfully? Athena. But here the meaning, it was not clear to whom she referred, right? Whether she referred to Archana or whether she referred to Athena. The meaning was not clear in this sentence. So here we need to repeat the noun Athena. Okay. Now the nouns or group of words that a pronoun refers to is called its antecedent. What is antecedent? The noun or group of words that pronouns refers to. So to which noun or to which group of words the pronoun refers, that is called as antecedent. When you use a pronoun, you should be sure that it refers to its antecedent clearly. So a pronoun should refer to its antecedent clearly. Be especially careful when you use the pronoun they. Now see, they have several books about Greek myths and library. Now they, now who are they here? So when you use they, you should be very careful. Because now it doesn't refer to any noun. We don't know who they are, right? Next, the meaning of they is unclear. As I told you, we don't know who they are. So the meaning of they is unclear. The sentence can be improved by rewriting it in the following manner. So how, if we write the sentence in this manner, then the meaning of they will be clear. For example, several books about myths are available at the library. What was the earlier sentence? They have several books about Greek myths at the library. So here the meaning of they was unclear. So instead of writing the sentence this way, if we write in this way, several books about myths are available at library, the meaning will be more clear. So let's move ahead. When using pronouns, you must also make sure that they agree with their antecedents in number, that is singular and plural, and gender. The gender of a noun may be masculine, that is male, feminine, that is female, or neuter, that is referring to female, that is neither male nor female. So let us see how the pronouns agree. The myth of Arachne is amusing and I enjoyed it. The myth of Arachne is amusing, I enjoyed it. Now here it is a pronoun. So it refers to what? It refers to myth. So here the meaning is clear, right? The bystanders see Athena, they watch her at loom. Now the bystanders see Athena. They means who here? They means the bystanders. It is plural, so we have used plural pronoun. So it means it agrees with the noun. Watch her. Her means who? That refers to Athena. So she is feminine. So we have used her. So in the first sentence, myth is the antecedent of pronoun it. Now as I told you, it refers to what? It refers to myth. It means myth is what? Myth is antecedent. Myth is what? It is antecedent. Now in second, bystanders, this is antecedent of they. And Athena is the antecedent of her. Okay. Let's move ahead. Now using pronouns correctly. Subject pronouns are used in compound subjects and object pronouns are used in compound objects. Now subject pronouns are used in compound subjects. You have learned what is compound subject, right? And what is compound object? Object pronouns are used in compound objects. For example, he and Carmen wrote a report on the subject. So now here he is used as a subject. So we cannot write him and Carmen because him is the object pronoun. Subject pronoun. Tell John and me about Hercules. So tell John and me. So me is here used as an object. And so we have used me, not I. I is a subject pronoun and me is an object pronoun. So here me is an object and not the subject. So we have used me. A preposition takes an object just as many verbs do. The object of a preposition can be simple or compound. Now object of preposition, it may be simple or compound. In either case, use an object pronoun as the object of the preposition. So in both the case, whether it is simple or compound, in both the case you have to use object pronoun as the object of the preposition. For example, Lee read a famous myth to me. Lee read a famous myth to John and me. So here object pronoun is used as the object of the preposition. Okay. Next, if you are not sure of which form of pronoun to use, say the sentence aloud with only pronoun as the subject or the object. Your ear will tell you which form is correct. So sometimes you may get confused, you may not understand which pronoun to use. So at such times you have to read the sentence aloud with only the pronouns as the subject or object. Okay. Whenever the pronoun I is a part of compound subject, it should always be placed after the other parts of the subject. So when we have to use I as a subject, as a part of a subject, at that time it should always be placed after the other parts of the subject. So I will come after the other parts of the subject, not before. Okay. Similarly, when the pronoun me is a part of compound object, it should go after the other parts of the object. So me, when we use me as an object pronoun with a compound object, at that time also me should go with the other part of, after the other parts of the object. Let us see examples. Lee and I read some ancient Roman myths. Now here see, I is a part of subject. Now, which is the subject? Lee and I. These are subjects, right? So, whenever I is the part of subject, it should come after the other part. You cannot say I and Lee. Lee and I. Okay, whenever I is a part of a subject, it will come after the other part of subject. Okay, next, mythology interests Lee and me. Now, Lee and me, this is the object, right? So, when me is a part of an object, at that time, me will come after the other part of the object. You cannot say mythology interests me and Lee. It is wrong. Mythology interests Lee and me. So, keep this in mind. In formal writing and speech, use a subject pronoun after a linking verb. In formal writing and speech, when you are talking formally or when you are writing formally, at that time, use a subject pronoun after a linking verb. So, after linking verb, you have to use the subject pronoun. So, after the linking verb, you have to use the subject pronoun. For example, the writer of this report was she. Now, was is a linking verb. So, after linking verb, use the pronoun. So, you can say this sentence as she was the writer of this report. But when you want to say the same thing formally, so in formal writing, she is the subject pronoun. Now, here, even if she is put at the end of the sentence, it is a subject, right? Because it is the doer of the action. So, at such times, when you formally you are writing or formally you are speaking, subject pronoun should come after linking verb. It is I. So, I. Okay? So, this is used after the linking verb is. Next. Second type is possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun. A possessive pronoun is a pronoun that shows who or what has something. Who or what has something means who owns something. Who possesses something. So for that we use possessive pronouns. A possessive pronoun may take the place of possessive noun. So, possessive pronoun may take place of possessive noun. Let us see the example. Homer's story is famous. Now, whose story? The story belongs to whom? Homer, right? So, now Homer is the possessor of the story. Homer possesses the story. So, we use here his. Homer's means his. His story is famous. This story is Homer's. Now, Homer's. Here it is used as object. Here it was used as subject. Now, this story is his. So, he, possessive pronoun for he, subjective is also his and objective is also his. So, possessive nouns are given in green, possessive pronouns in red. Homer's is a possessive noun, his is a possessive pronoun. Okay, let's move ahead. Now, possessive pronouns have two forms. One form is used before a noun, other form is used alone. Okay, now possessive pronouns, they have how many forms? Two forms. One form is used before a noun, other form is used alone. So, let us see the possessive pronouns. Singular and plural.
So the pronouns which are used before the nouns are singular, my, your, his, her and its, and plural are your and their. So these are used before the nouns. The pronouns which are used alone, singular, mine, yours, his, hers, its, ours, yours, theirs. Possessive pronouns are not written with apostrophes. This is very important. Possessive pronouns are not written with apostrophes.
Possessive nouns are written with apostrophes, but possessive pronouns are not written with apostrophes.
The pronoun its, for example, shows possession. The word its, on the other hand, is a contraction of it is.
Okay, now it, without apostrophe, it shows possession.
And its with apostrophe, it is the short form of it is. Okay. Its central character is Odysseus.
Now its. So here it is used without apostrophe. It means it shows it is a possessive pronoun.
It's about the adventures of Odysseus. So it's means it is. It is a short form. It is. Okay. I hope you have understood what are personal pronouns and what are possessive pronouns. Thank you.